going to be a complete 4-1, and it's based on the speed of how this Amuju is going to be rotating in. Final pick for the side of Empress Phoenix is going to be that Akali. What do you think about the draft, Dior?
Yeah, so far, you mentioned earlier, into the late game, the scaling of EPX is very, very good. They have the Kai'Sa as an insurance for the late game. So I always respect Kai'Sa as long as she can reach the late game. So that's going to be the challenge right here. But I think this Kai'Sa is going to have an easy time considering that the jungler of the blue side is an Amumu. And they have the Malphite. The lineup's quite slow. You mentioned that earlier. Quite slow, especially in the early game. So I think Kai'Sa is going to have a good time here in the early game. The plan here for blue team is basically on the team fights. They will look for appeal as much as possible. They have the Malphite to initiate. And then they have Amumu also if they need further time. And then Ahri can charm someone and Varus can ultimate that someone. And then they can focus on that. Fiora can definitely add to the damage. And then if they are up one champion more than the enemy team, and they can look to collapse by that point. So I think that's their win condition right here. Alright, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Wild Rift. Welcome to game number one between Include Yakuzi versus Empress Phoenix. And Isaac, man, do the honors. Please do the introductions for blue team first.
Alright, for Include Yakuzi, we've got Auroran on that virus, Macaroon on the Ahri. We have Kanashi on that Amumu, Rain XV on Malphite, and of course, Katkus on the Fiora.
All right, and on the red side we have there's an invade right here by Katkus, but it's gonna be a pretty safe early game for both sides, so we're gonna have time to introduce them. On the red side, the man is EPX, it's Empress Phoenix, Akane on the Corki mid, Kazuri on the jungler, Olaf, Aoi on the Akali, it's a Baron laner Akali, but it's is standing in the dragon lane. As of the moment, we have Dora as the Alistar support, and we have Bowie on the Kai'Sa ADR right here. And again, early game natin dito, win conditions for both sides. Auroran, they still have a good late game right here. Varus is pretty strong also into the late game, but their win condition right here is during the team fights. They can always look for a pickup right here, peel someone off the other team and kill that and win the game through numbers game. And on the opposite side naman, I think they're gonna go for a late game right here. They have the Kai'Sa, which is gonna be very slow in the start. So yeah, if they can drag this late game to late game, I think EPX will have this. What do you think, Kai'Sa?
Well, I like the lane swap. Specifically, mm-hmm. You want that lane swap so that your ADC can get ahead fast. And that's exactly what EPX are doing. Instead of matching up with the Malphite and the Varus, you want to put this Kai'Sa in a really good matchup. And then, hold that thought. They're going to go for a dive onto the Varus here. Here comes the Olaf timing in as well. They're doing a lot of damage onto the Malphite and the Varus, but it's not going to be enough for the Akali to make it and join that fight. That is going to be a failed rotation coming in, but it's going to shove back the members of INC really far, allowing time for this Akali to warm up even more.
True. Good attempt right there by the red team, EPX. I see the plan, but it is just the blue team being prepared for that. And they're out of there. The ward in the tri-bush really helped them to ring the alarm that the Olaf is on his way. And good attempt. Mutik na mamatay dito si Varus, but Varus found an opening and said, "See you later, guys. That's time wasted for you." And I would say that is a small win on to the blue side, wasting the time of the Olaf. Olaf is back here, and I think blue team this time I don't think they know about this. Olaf is gonna be going in. He's gonna focus on the Varus right here. Varus will try to run away, but Akali is gonna go for it. Akali doing so much damage, but Varus is again out of there. See you later, guys. And it's a TP for both.
Oh, they just backed off from that. Still, this is buying a lot of time for the Akali to actually farm up. This is good stuff coming in from EPX. Yes, they're down at a moment, but then when you consider the matchups, when you consider what kind of composition they have moving forward into the mid game, the late game, it's going to be a lot scarier.
True. And looking at the gold lead right now, it's still anybody's game. 0-0 on the board. No thirds taking damage as of the moment. So it's a pretty even game as we enter the 3-minute 30 mark.
the next objective will be this Drake right here, which is going to be the Mountain Drake. And I think that is going to break the status quo of this game, and possibly a fight will break out here, and we will see scores on the board pretty soon.
Now, looking at the map right now, we have a 4-minute game. This is where the Mountain Drake starts to spawn. It's a big fight coming up, Leoric. Are you ready?
I think so. Mm-hmm. Dragon is already up, right?
Yep.
The map says yes. It should be up already, but both teams are not looking at it. Sorry about that. I was looking at the stream instead, so it was delayed. So nalito ako. Bakit naging 2 minutes bigla?
Up na siya. Okay, 4 minutes 20 seconds, and we have a 500 gold lead for INC. They are gonna battle it out for this Mountain Drake right now.
Right.
So far, so good for EPX. They have the position here to take out this Mountain Drake. We're still waiting on INC to actually get ready for it, but they have big ults. They're gonna dive in. Here comes the Iron with the Charm onto this Alistar. Follow up with the ult, but then the package's gonna be there. Dealing damage is gonna be the Morgan. They do not have enough. They're gonna take out the Amumu though, and now it's falling apart for INC. Kai'Sa free hits, going left, right, center, rockets here and there. The Corki's still going. They will take out 4, and that is gonna be a big win for EPX, taking that Mountain Drake as well. Now, when it went to a 500 gold lead for INC, it is a 3k gold advantage for Empress Phoenix.
Right, what a fight right there by EPX, man. What an entry. I saw the attempt right there of the Amumu going in with the bandage, but when Amumu sent his ultimate, didn't hit anyone, and that cost blue team a lot. Even 4 champions on their side went down, and also the first third of the game going on to the red side. This is a very big win in this early part of the game for Empress Phoenix, and now they take the driver's seat of this game. That's a 4k gold lead, 0-4 on the scoreboard, 1-0 on the third count.
Oh man, considering what happened there, now you're gonna think, okay, what's INC gonna be doing? Are they gonna be trying to challenge again? Because this Rift Herald is gonna be spawning in a moment. You have a significant lead, especially with a late game composition, so they're gonna press the advantage here. The question is how INC are gonna be coming back from this and take control over the map and over the game yet again. They had a pretty good start, but now things are starting to fall apart here.
Yeah, but it's still early in the game to really know for sure. Yes, you can throw a bit at the early game. It is very risky. It will put your team in danger. Maybe you can't recover at this point, but still earlier part in the game. They can still find an opening right here. Like this one right here. Red team is trying to take the Rift Herald aggressively right here. Are they gonna take up in it? They won't be able to. Alistar is zoning them out, and it's gonna be a fight right here. Amumu sends out his ultimate. Alistar is already very low, but somehow still alive. And damage just keep flying in, and it's gonna be up. Varus takes the rocket, but he's alive, right?
Alright, Varus alive. There. Oh my god.
Alright.
This Varus could have died.
Yeah, 6-0 on the scoreboard. Rift Herald taken by the red team. Good job by the Alistar right there, man. Tanking everyone up, zoning everyone away. And blue team did not really have an opening right there to contest for the Rift Herald. And now they have that in the pockets. Let's see what they can do with that right there. Up at the top, it's gonna be Katkus trying to pressure the top turret, but the cavalry is here and he is out of there.
I love that. I'll be honest. Loved every single moment of it. If you look at that kind of play coming in from Empress Phoenix, they had a system in mind. They wanted to make sure someone was blocking a potential movement coming in, and then it's going to allow INC to just continue barreling forward.
Yes, blue team right now, they're trying to play aggressive, looking for an opening right here. They went for the push at the bottom. They saw Corki and focused on him, but Corki was prepared for that, and Corki was out of there. And at the top, 3 champions right here are pressuring the top lane. Let's see what is going to be happening right here. It's going to be an exchange for both turrets. Red team is already there, knocking on the top turret. Who is going to take this first? It is going to be red team. Fiora will not. Man, take the turret, man. There's 3 of you, only 1 of me. It's yours. Fiora's head. Rift Herald is summoned at the top to help this push. They're not done yet. Kai'Sa is pretty comfortable right here at this fight, man.
Yep, off-cam kill though. That's gonna be an Akali dead bot side. This Herald is already pushing in top side though. So now it's gonna be a 3v1. They're gonna try their best to defend it, but this Olaf is just huge. Fiora flashing away.
Ooh, no!
But Killer Instinct coming in from under the tower is not gonna be enough to take out Katkus here. But oh my god. Woo! That was close. Second tier tower for the side of INC is gonna be going down top side though. But you know, going back to what I was saying earlier, this Akali died bot side so that INC could get a first tier tower. That's fine in some cases, but considering that you got a kill and a tower in return for losing your second tier tower topside might be a really bad trade-off. But now, going into this, this is gonna be the second Drake of the game. They're gonna battle it out. 2-6 right now in terms of kills. Empress Phoenix having a really good lead right now. But now, I don't think there's a way for them to actually contest it. Alistair's gonna be coming in to try to zone them out. That's a 4-man knock-up. Here comes a dive coming in from the Akali. They're just gonna wipe the floor. They're gonna take one out. They're gonna take another one and make that another and another. That's 4 dead for the side of INC. Fiora is gonna be trying her best to actually just split push and save this game, but it's not gonna be enough. It's starting to get out of hand. Empress Phoenix are running rampant, Leoric. What can INC do now?
Man, this is going to be an uphill battle from INC at this point on. That Akali kill earlier at the bottom lane actually was the first on the board for the blue side, but that's not going to be enough. That fight right there for the Dragon, I would have not just contested for it. It was a 5v4 for them, and the gold lead is on the red side. So red team, you know, it's gonna be very painful coming into that fight. But kudos to that Malphite, man. I mean, kudos to the entry right there of the Alistar, knocking everyone up. And basically from that point on, it was evasive maneuvers from blue side, but still they fell four champions down, 3-10 on the scoreboard, and it's gonna be a 5k gold lead onto the red side.
I feel like INC have a really nice strategy going there. That thought of Fiora getting caught in no woman's land. That is gonna be Katkus going down from a 4-man rotation. This could potentially open up a Baron. But going back to what I was saying here, in Blue Jacuzzi, they have a setup, they have a plan going on. They want a way to actually set up fights. But then they keep getting interrupted by Dora. And now Varus is going to be taking out the Akali here. This might be their chance. They're going to try to turn. That move will dive it in. Catch it out. 4. Not going to be enough though. Going to get absolutely demolished by the damage of EVX. They're going to take one more. Make that another one. The stasis is not going to keep this Ahri alive. And with the Killer Instinct along with the Corki coming in, that is going to be another wipe. Coming in for Include Yakuzi. 3 dead, not exactly a wipe, but then they got wiped out in that last fight.
True, man, this is getting out of hand already. Look at the gold lead ballooning to 7k from 5k earlier, plus the Baron buff right here onto the red side. Let's see what setup they are going to be doing with this Baron buff push. Someone needs to go to the bottom. That's going to be a very strong push if that happens. 3 champions here on the red side onto the mid turret. Fiora is going to be here, but I don't think they can do anything about here. 1-3-1 setup now. They're going to shift their focus onto the bottom side. Akali is going to split push at the top, but Akali is not a threat at all. He doesn't have the Baron buff right here. Bottom turret goes down and they are up already. All right, I think that's it for them. Is that the push already? They're gonna stop the push that point on. All right, pretty cyan yung Baron buff. They still have, they can squeeze something out of that Baron buff still. But yeah, they're not done yet. They're gonna go for this. They're just waiting for the wave right here. And here comes push number 2 for the red team. Empress Phoenix going up to the top, meet up with Akali, with the rendezvous with Olaf, and here we go. Yeah, pretty weak push right here from red team. So I think they're just waiting for a good time na lang. I don't think they're gonna pressure this much. Very, very tactical gaming right here. Right, don't risk it. We're in the lead. Let's just do this slowly but surely. That should be the plan, and I think that's gonna be it for that push.
Yeah, I like the methodical play coming in from EPX. They're really thinking about, okay, what can we do to maintain this lead and still make sure that they don't get anything in return? This is exactly what they're doing. They're controlling the waves, making sure that there is no way for Include Yakuzi to get out. And then they're going to get the farm, they're going to steal the jungle, and they're going to position themselves in places where it's going to be hard for INC to contest. Now, EPX are going to be eyeing this third Drake of the game. It's an Ocean Drake. They already have two so far, and it's looking pretty good for them. But yes, with a third Drake, imagine three permanent buffs on your team. It's going to be really crazy. It's going to be really scary as well. They need to make sure that Aurorian on this virus does crazy amounts of damage going into the fights. And at the same time, they want to make sure Kanashi and Rain have this wombo combo that just allows this virus to just continue free hitting, allowing the Ahri to continue damaging, and then just eventually wipe out Ember's Phoenix. The problem with that, though, this Akali, IOE on this Akali is going to be crazy. The Olaf is huge. Dora on this Alistar has been complete MVP. With the zoning, with the pushbacks, with making sure that no one gets to contest, it's a hard ask, but they're going to need to try because the next Baron's going to be spawning here.
Yes, man, that's the theory right there. We know the wombo combo, but it's just that they're not able to really deliver on the plan that they have. And here is a Death Bush setup right here. No, they're going to be resetting right here. But yeah, that's the plan of blue side, but I don't think it's already at the point of the game that they can do anything. Even if they land those combos, I don't think they can take the game just as yet. Their opening right here, I would say, is just to try to contest for this for this Baron take right here, because if they just give out this Baron, it's just game over, the same story. So might as well just give up, if not take the Baron, right? So all out, I think it's gonna be the last stand with the Baron, with this Baron take right here, and it's gonna be a very good chess match right here. Battle of the wards, and here we go. Slow in. Let me take a deep breath right here, as Baron is already 3 plates in. Baron is already very low. Blue team really has no answer right here, and Akali's gonna initiate right fight right there, and napakalit ng buhay na Akali. Akali goes down first. This can be an opening right here, but with the Baron buff, it's gonna be very difficult. Two champions, one champion down. Malphite. Stasis is not gonna be enough. I think Ahri is next in the menu, and there it is. Ahri goes down. Next, they're focusing on Amumu. Somehow Amumu is alive, is out of there, but here comes the victory push. Go Fiora. Fiora is gonna try to split push at the bottom, and I would recommend Yo Fiora defend this third instant, and there it is. Fiora is gonna go home, but what can two champions do right here? They can push away the red team. All right, red team will
teleport.
All right, right here. So again, hindi pa tapos, right? They just waited for the wave right there. They will not go for the third aggressively, the Nexus aggressively. A reset for both sides. So again, slow, methodical death for the blue side. That's the plan of the red team, and they're doing that right now.
I feel like DPX could have pushed the issue there. Four of them, two of INC, they could have gone for the game there.
True.
But again, you know, slow, methodical, making sure it's 100% when it comes to the perfection of their execution. And true, so far, so good. 5-17. It's a 10k gold lead for the side of Empress Phoenix, and they're just looking really nice. But the thing here now is, you saw that last fight. The virus is starting to get scary. The Akali dove in, gets absolutely destroyed. So now, if they manage to find a way to kite, create space, allow free hits, this might turn around big and cause a lot of problems, especially for the side of Empress Phoenix. They're not out of the woods yet, considering what they're doing.
Yes, true, man. The buff is burned. No more Baron buff right here. So, but Akali has found a Fiora right here for her meal. Let's see what the fight is gonna look like here. Fiora is in on top right here, but Fiora doesn't have the ultimate anymore. Oh, Fiora is winning, man. Akali is out of here. Wanted to get that dance, but immediately regretted her decision. Fiora dealing so much damage. But here at the bottom, it's gonna be a fight right here. Bottom. Oh no, they're not pushing. Alright, ito, hindi po tapos. Akali and the dance with the Fiora is not yet done. What a fight right here. Fiora gets the Mystic Fruit right here and continues the dance. Let me have this dance. Akali, let's see who. Mas thrilling pa to sa laro na yan, di ba? Right, Infernal Drake has already spawned. Oh no, Killjoy si Kaisa. Kaisa is in and will help the Akali to get the Fiora. And now they are on for the Dragon Take. But blue team has a good position right here. Only three champions. Only three champions here on the red side. This is the opening day. Might be the opening they're looking for. And there it is. But blue team gets the dragon. It's the Elder Drake right here. And that's mission accomplished. They are already on their way. Evasive maneuvers right here.
But the baseman, Kaisa, is Kaisa! Doing it at the base. Nexus is already up for the, on in the menu. Oh, hindi, hindi. Kaisa?
That's a triple for the... Oh my god!
Ang gulo. What a fight. But Nexus, man, is already there. I don't think Ari can do anything about that. There it is. It is gonna be Empress Phoenix getting the first W of this series. What do you think about that, Isaac? That was crazy, man.
Some stuff. They risked a take on that Elder. They went for a really nice play there. They know that Maui is gonna be really big when it comes to the split push and that Nexus take.